Does dipping make you a sinner? Oh dear God, I hope not. Hey everybody, welcome to the Mudjug One channel. I am your personal host. We have an interesting topic to discuss today, if you couldn't tell by the title. I already got a dipping, we just had lunch, but I'm gonna put a little pinch in there, a little filler in there for Jesus, if you know what I'm saying. Since that is the topic of discussion for today. Little bit of that grizz green, little dark grizz green. We do have a new mud jug. Yes, we have had numerous requests for some sort of Jesus jug. Here it is, folks. We have the cross on one side, and we have, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Bible verse right there. Now, we figured we'd do it on black with a nice little gold, you know, Bible look to it. Believe it or not, we've had tons of people ask us for a jug like this. So we're gonna have a little conversation about a recent experience I had when I met someone. So I met someone about, this was somebody, I went out to visit my dad in Arizona, and I met one of his neighbor's friends. It just doesn't matter. And they're like, what do you do? And I said, well, I sell spittoons. Spittoons? What do you mean spittoons? And I said, well, spittoons for, you know, smokeless tobacco users. We need something to spit in. We don't want to be spitting in bottles, cups, and cans. And I have a company that sells spittoons. And unbeknownst to me, this person was quite religious, and that's fine. You want to be religious, heavy, hardcore religious, that's fine. I don't have a problem with that. But this person started to judge me a little bit, okay? Because I sold spittoons. The conversation kind of got a little bit escalated. They basically told me that I was a sinner for, number one, using smokeless tobacco product. Also, for providing a product that encourages people to use smokeless tobacco products, that being a mud jug portable spittoon. So I was kind of taken back. I'm like, whoa, I never really seen my dipping habit and my company as being sinful. I actually have read the Bible. I've actually read the Bible twice, I think, in the last 10 years. So I do know a thing or two about a thing or two when it comes to things of that nature. So at the end of the day, this conversation basically went nowhere because I didn't back down from my opinion. Imagine that. And this person was so adamant about making me wrong for being a dipper and for selling spittoons. So I want to know, number one, how many of you believe in God? Because nowadays, you know, I don't know. There's so much going on with people not even knowing their gender. I don't even know if people have religious beliefs like they used to 10 years ago. I don't know. So I want to know, number one, your thoughts on God and or religion. But more importantly, I want to know if people who watch this video agree with or disagree with the fact that using any kind of tobacco products is being sinful. So I will say that using any type of smokeless tobacco is not quite as bad as doing certain types of hardcore drugs, okay? Now, am I justifying my use of smokeless tobacco by saying that? I guess maybe you could say I am, I don't know. But it beats, you know, mainlining some heroin off the street is my point, right? I think anything within reason, anything used in moderation, as long as it's legal, I don't think it can be classified as a sin. Now, I will tell you that I do know a few pastors who are dippers. So if dipping and or using tobacco, period, is a sin, then why would someone who's a pastor use smokeless tobacco? I know pastors who have a couple beers on the weekend, you know, when they're watching a football game. Is there anything wrong with that? I don't think so. It doesn't control them. There's a lot of Bible verses and quotes that talk about, you know, addiction allowing something to control you. Does this control me? No. Can I go a week, 2 weeks, forever without a dip? Yeah. I'm not going to lose my marbles. Maybe there's people out there that will lose their marbles. I don't know. Do I prefer to have a dip? Absolutely. Do I dip about a can a day? Yeah. Is that a problem? Maybe, but doesn't mean that I need it. It doesn't mean that I just cannot live without it. So if you think dipping is not a sin, then I suggest you grab you a Trinity Mud Jug. We didn't really want to call this the Jesus Jug. I mean, we didn't really want it to sound, it kind of rings nicely, but we didn't want it to sound too, like, disrespectful. You know, we're just trying to offer mud jugs to people that request certain things that, and you know, there's no religious films out there, so this is the next best thing. We're just giving it a shot. So in other news, besides the coronavirus just killing everybody in the world, by the way, let me know your comments down below on that. I mean, I don't know if this stuff is getting blown out of proportion. I'm not going to be going anywhere outside the U.S. anytime soon. Not that I was going to anyway, but is this coronavirus just all hype? Is it just, like, I don't know what's going on. Are they letting this out of the bag because of the federal election coming up this year? I don't know. I'm a bit of a conspiracy theorist, as most of you know. But I really don't know what to believe. Really, like, comment down below. Tell me something. Something good. Don't just waste my time. Tell me something good. Tell me you have a brother who works somewhere and there's people dying left and right. Or tell me that you have a brother that works at, I don't know, the CIA and it's all bullshit. I don't know. Something. Please give me a bone to chew on. Hockey playoffs are coming up, folks. I know I keep talking about hockey, but it's crazy. There's less than 20 games and it's just tighter than tight. I'm just saying. We will see. So that's about it for me, folks. You know, hopefully people take the time to write a nice comment down below and tell me that Jesus loves me and everything's going to be just fine and I'll be happy, happy, happy. So I'll leave you with this. Always be a man and reach for that can. And if you think dipping makes you a sinner, boy, oh boy, you ain't a winner. I'm out. In those sports. Number one, hockey. Then, of course, football. Then you have wrestling. There's a lot of wrestlers who are dippers. Fighters, MMA. And, of course, you got baseball. So, I want to know people's opinion. What sports have players that dip the most? Now, obviously, baseball is...